before upgrading your AMD Ryzen CPU, you first want to update your motherboard's BIOS. This is especially important if you're wanting to slot in a Ryzen 3000 or 5000 series CPU into a 300 or 400 series motherboard. If you don't know how to update your motherboard BIOS, I have a video popping up in the cards right now to help you with that. Once you've got your BIOS updated, we can start by unplugging our PC from power and opening up the side panel of our case. A quick word of warning, it is possible to damage your CPU by accidentally shocking it. If your body is all charged up with static electricity and you touch your CPU, or any other component in your PC for that matter, there is a chance you could fry that component with an electrostatic discharge. A quick and easy method to mitigate this risk though is to simply touch a metal portion of your PC's case. This will equalize the static charge between you and your PC and prevent you from damaging any of your components. I've been using this technique for over 15 years, have built dozens of PCs using it, and to date have killed a grand total of 0 PC components. Okay, now we're ready to remove our CPU cooler. Depending on what CPU cooler you have, this process is going to look very different for you than what I'm showing here. But basically, you'll have some screws or retention bolts of some kind you're going to have to remove in order to access your CPU. Before we go yanking our cooler off though, we want to give it a little twist to break the bond with the thermal paste. I've seen a lot of pictures online of people removing their CPU cooler from their Ryzen CPU and finding their CPU essentially glued to their cooler. Giving the cooler a little twist helps to avoid this issue, and once the cooler is freed up, we can lift our cooler off without a problem. Depending on your CPU cooler, you may have to unplug your cooler's fan cable from your motherboard at this point to swap your CPU out. As for me, I can just move the pump block of my all-in-one liquid cooler out of the way here and move on to the next step, which is cleaning the thermal paste from both our cooler and our CPU's integrated heat spreader. I typically use a paper towel and some isopropyl alcohol for this. We can now remove our old CPU from the socket by first pressing this retention arm slightly to the side to get it past the little tab holding it down, and then lift the arm up until it kind of clicks into place here. We can now grip the sides of our CPU like so and lift it straight out of the socket. When handling your CPU, you want to make sure you do not touch the gold pins on the bottom of it. They are very delicate and can be damaged quite easily. If you hold your CPU by the sides like this though, you'll be just fine. After setting our CPU aside somewhere safe, we can now take our new CPU out of its box and slot it into our motherboard. To help us correctly orient our CPU in the socket, there is a little gold triangle on one corner of the CPU, which corresponds with another triangle on the socket itself. We can now gently place our CPU into the socket like so, and before lowering the retention arm, I like to give the CPU a little jiggle just to make sure it's fully seated in the socket. Once we're sure it's properly seated, we can press our retention arm down and lock our new CPU in place. If your new CPU came with a cooler and you're planning to use it, it will most likely have thermal paste pre-applied to the cooler, so you can skip this next step. But for those reusing their old cooler, we now need to apply some thermal paste to the top of our CPU's integrated heat spreader. I'm going to be using this Corsair TM30 paste, link in the video description, and what is known as the line method for the application. We're now ready to install our CPU cooler. When screwing your cooler back in place, you'll want to alternate between the different screws, tightening them a little bit at a time until they won't tighten down anymore. It's important to alternate between screws because if you tighten one all the way down and then move to another screw, you run the risk of damaging your CPU by putting too much pressure on one side and pinching it as you begin tightening down one of the other sides. With our cooler now securely in place, all we have left to do is plug our fan cable back in, if we had to unplug it earlier. And before putting your side panel back on, you'll want to plug your PC in and boot it up to make sure everything is working correctly. And that's pretty much it.